All right, guys. Able to do some information, but I was able to talk to a couple of you. Today, you guys are going to continue to work on area, but we're going to move on from parallelograms and triangles to trapezoids. So let's go ahead and get started. I want you to do a little review. I want you to find the answers to these 8 problems. I'm going to give you guys probably about 10 minutes to work on them. If you need less than that, that's great. But go ahead and get these done. All right, pause the video, and then when you're ready, you can start again, and we'll go over the answers. All right, so to find the area of each parallelogram, remember that the area is, oh, let me grab my pen. There we go. Area is base times height. Okay, that's our formula. So each time we're going to come in here and we're going to do it. Now, I've got a calculator off to the side of my desk that I can work on. So just so you know, I did ask you guys to do yours by hand, but I'm going to just shortcut this process. So my first one, so for number one, it would be 20 times 12 equals the area. So I get the area of this one is 320 centimeters squared. For number two, I went ahead and did 15 times 9. So area equals 15 as the base, 9 as the height. And I'm going to say the answer is 135 inches squared. For number three, we've got an area, and remember our vertical is going to be that dotted line. That's the height. So we're going to have area equals our base at 20 and our height over here at 6. So I would have my area being 120 meters squared. And number four, I'm going to have to take some space and cancel this in a second once I get this last little bit. Is going to be area equals our height, which our base, which is 15, our height, which is 30. So we're going to say our area is 450 feet squared. That's actually a really large space. So that gives us our first 4 problems. Okay. And then let's go ahead and take a look at those last 4. So for number 5, we're still at area equals base times height. If the area of the parallelogram shaped patio is a height of 6 and a width of 6 meters. So we're going to find the area, and where this would really be helpful in math is I would say if I want to pave that patio with paved stones or put down some type of gravel on the bottom, I would use area to help determine how much space I need or how much I need to buy so that I could buy the right amount. So we'd find that we would need, at least for this one, you need 60 meters squared worth of material to flatten that space to be able to cover that space with whatever you're going to buy. Okay. So back to the number one on the bottom section. So our formula changes now. For triangles, it's area equals 1/2 base height. Okay. And remember, height is always going to be considered as the distance from up and down. It's that dotted line. It's where the 90 degree mark is right here. Okay. So there it goes. For our first one, area equals 1/2 of the base, which in our case is 10 times 5. Now, remember, one of the great things I mentioned in the video is you don't have to do half. You don't have to go in order from left to right. But in this case, it'd be really easy to go half of 10 is 5 times 5. So my area is 25 centimeters squared. That's number one. All right, I'll clear this off in just a second, and then I'll go ahead and show you guys the next one. All right, so our next one is going to be the same basic question. So I've got area equals 1/2 times 11 times 15. Now, it doesn't matter if I put my base and my height in different orders because the two are commutative between the two. Now, in this case, I won't get a perfect number. I won't be able to go ahead and go, oh, those are the perfect even number that way. So I'm just going to take half of 15 because that's my bigger number. So area equals 11 times 7.5. And again, I'm just going to shortcut this. I have a calculator sitting on the desk right next to me. My area is 82.5 meters squared. And my last question, that triangular sail on the sailboat, for my last number 3, is area equals 1/2 of 40 times 25. Okay, and again, this one's really great because I can take half of 40 really quickly and go 20 times 25. And 20 times 25 helps if I can type it right. I want to make sure I'm right. It's 500. So the area of this square is 500 feet squared. It's a really large thing. It's about the size of most people's houses, the first floor of their house. So we get to take a look at those couple problems. All right, now we're going to move on to our next piece, and we're going to look at area of a trapezoid. So different trapezoids, let me clear my screen. Trapezoids are a little different because of the way they're built. They're not set up like a base times height, and they're not set up like a half of base times height where I can take a triangle or a rectangle and cut it in half and get my 1/2 base times height, because this has two different bases. It has a base one and a base two, and they're two different sizes. So that's one of the things we're going to have to be aware of as we start working through this problem. Okay. Let's take a look at our next part. So this is how we're going to talk about this for a second. Clear my screen. If I take this trapezoid and I want to turn it into a rectangle, if I had a pair of scissors, I'd have you guys cut one out. Say, okay, if I cut this part right here and I move it over here, what did I just do? I've created myself a rectangle. So I could actually use that starting my area equals base times height. I can start as that as my base formula, okay? But what I have to think about is, what did I do? I took this part and put it on top and I ignored this. So one of the pieces I'm going to have to do is go, well, how do I figure out what is the average or the middle, this part right here, between these two lines right here? Okay. Well, what if I took half of that and half of this and put it up here? I would create my little piece. So the way the formula works, where a rectangle, area of a rectangle, is base times height. The area of a trapezoid is going to say, I'm going to find the average of the two bases. So I'm going to go base one plus base two divided by two. I'm going to show you another way you could just times the height. Or I could write it an alternate method of 1/2 of base one plus base two times height. Either one works. It doesn't really matter how you do it. I don't mind either formula. They're both, you could see either one depending on what teacher you have. But in this just shows you, and I don't care which one we use, but this is our area of a trapezoid formula. So let's take a look at, and that's exactly what I have in your notes. Okay. I have that 1/2 of base one plus base two times height. Okay. And this is where our order of operations comes into play with our GEMDIS. The first thing we're going to do is what's inside this box. Then we can multiply it by 1/2 or a height by 1/2 and figure out whatever we want to do. Okay. So let's take a couple of practice problems like this. So now we'll do our first one together, and then we'll do that second one in a moment. So if we take our first shape up here, number one, I'm going to take my formula and say 1/2 is my base, base one plus base two times the height. So I'm going to take that problem into account and go, okay, now I can plug in what I know. It doesn't matter if you say this is base one or this is base two. There doesn't matter as long as you have them both represented. So we're going to have 1/2 of 5 plus 12 times 7. Okay. Now at this point, it's pretty much commutative. I can multiply all these together, but the best thing I want to do right here is add those two together to get 1/2 of 17 times 7. Again, I can't really divide any of these evenly, so I'm going to take half of 17 and say that's okay. That's 8.5 times 7. And I won't even use my calculator. I'll come over here and do the math. 8.5 times 7. 5 carry the 3. So I get 59.5 inches squared. And we talked about yesterday why it's inches squared, and that because there's actually inches on all these pieces. And when you multiply them together, you got to keep those into account. Okay. So I'm going to clear this off, and I want you guys to try number two, try the U try, and see if you guys can come up with the answer on these. This time it has a decimal. It's not going to change anything, but it's going to be an even number. So work the same formula from there and try number two. Pause the video and go from there. All right, so if I do this first one, set it up as area equals 1/2 of base one. So our base one, let's say, is 4 plus 7.6 times our height, which is 3, which is, again, that vertical dotted line. Okay. Doesn't matter if it's turned right, left, up, down. It's where that 90 degree mark is. That's the key right there. Okay. Think about how you measure height. Your doctor won't have you lean against the wall to see how tall you are. They want you to stand up straight so that you guys can see that height. So let's put our stuff together. 1/2 of 11, that was wrong, of 10, 10.6 times 3. Now, in this case, I want to take half of this number. It's going to be the easier one to work with. 5.3 times 3 equals my area. And finally, area is going to be 15.9, in this case, meters squared. Okay. So again, we're still working that same idea. This one would be a little harder to cut to get the same to turn into a rectangle, but it gives you the idea. All right, let's try another one. Let's clear my screen and go from here. So the trapezoid, now I'm asking you a different way around. I'm giving you some information. I'm giving you the area, and you're going to work just like we talked about on the other ones. Now, instead of me having you're plugging into the same formula, 1/2 base times base one plus base two times height. You're going to go ahead and plug in all the information you know now. So we're going to say 108 is equal to 1/2. My base is 12 plus 15 times height. I don't know the height. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come over here and combine all my like terms here. I'm going to put these together. So that's 27. Half of 27 is 13.5 times h is equal to 108. So just like we were talking about on previous days, you're going to divide everything by 13 and 5 tenths. I'm going to cheat and use my calculator and be real honest. And I'm going to come up that h is equal to 8. So my height is 8. I've got my answer there so that I know it's 8 feet long. Okay. I want you to try yours and see what you come up with. Go ahead and pause the video now, and then I'll go over the answer with you. All right. So let's try the same one. So area equals 1/2 of base one plus base two times our height. Again, let's plug in what we know right away. Our area is 487.5 feet, square feet, is equal to 1/2 of 25 plus 40 times height. Now that I've got all that plugged in, add those together. 487.5 equals 1/2 of 65 times the height. Now half of 65 happens to be 32.5 times the height equals 487.5. And again, I'm going to cheat and use my calculator. Yes, you get to do yours by hand. And I'm going to find out that my 15 is equal to my height. So my answer is 15 feet. Okay. So that's working out the first two types. Let's take a look at the next kind. More real life. A lot of shapes and a lot of things in real life actually are shaped like a trapezoid. You can see the state of Montana, some of these counties. Osceola County happens to be in Florida. It's not far from Disney. So if we can use you can use this information to kind of figure out the approximate area of a county. And that makes sense because that does come into play with tax information. So if we take that first problem, we have our same information. Area equals 1/2. Our base is 60, one of our bases is 16, the other is 48, and my height is 51 miles. So I'm going to come in here and add this up. 1/2, 16 plus 48 is 64 times 51. Put these two together because they're even. I want to make my life easier. So area equals 32 times 51. Again, I'm cheating. I'm using a calculator. No, you don't get to. I know I'm horrible and mean and you have to do it yourself. So my area, come on, pen, there we go. My area equals 1,632 square miles. Okay, go ahead and figure out the basic shape of Montana, the basic square miles of area of Montana. See how big that state really is. All right, pause the video and see what you come up with. All right, now that you've done that, let's take a look at the problem. So area equals 1/2 of 542 plus 479 times 285. So 542 plus 179, that gives me 1, carry the 1, 2, carry the 1. I get 1,021 miles and 285. Now I just got to do my 1/2. Now, neither of these are perfect. So we'll do half of 1,021. That's 510.5 miles times 285. So the area of Montana is 145,492.5 miles squared. That state is huge. Okay. You could even use this to find the area of Georgia, because Georgia is roughly a trapezoid as well, if you think about the picture. All right, let's take a look at the last kind of problem we're going to take a look at. Now, I thought I'd throw one of these in just to kind of have a little bit of a next step level in your problem. So you're going to find the area of a trapezoid. Now, one of the things we got to keep in mind when we're working with any of these area problems is that if I have an area, if I have formulas or units that are not the same, I need to make sure I make all the units the same before you plug them in. So if I'm working with a problem like this, this one's feet, this one's feet, this one's inches. So I'm going to have to come over and go, all right, 81.6 divided by 12. So I'd say, okay, this goes into it 6 times, that's 72. And then I get, okay, so I get 9 left over, 9.6, drop my decimal. 12 goes into 96 8 times. So this is really 6.8 feet. So this is what I'm going to put into my formula. Now I can change them all to inches as well, but it makes the most sense to change it to feet. All right, so now that I've got this, I'm going to put it in my formula. A equals 1/2 of 6.8 plus 3.4 times 3.7. So I'm going to add those two together. That gives me 10.2. So half of 10.2 times 3.7 gives me 5.1 times 3.7. And I'm using a calculator because I'm being lazy. Area equals 18.87 feet squared. There we go. Okay. All right. Your job is to work on the next one. My suggestion would be to make, I've already got two that are inches. I might change it to feet. I might change them both to feet, or I might change them both to inches. It's up to you. I always look to say, can I make them smaller so that my multiplication can be quicker and easier in my head? Okay. Try and listen next. Now you try and see what you come up with. All right, so I would have changed mine to feet. So I would have said this is 2 feet, this is 4 feet. So now I do 1/2 of 2 plus 4 times 3. So 6 times 3, half of 6 times 3 is 3 times 3. So my answer happens to be 9 feet squared. That's a lot easier math than trying to change this and working this as 36 inches. My numbers are much smaller this way. It makes the most sense to go to the larger unit if possible, because it makes my number smaller. Just like here, I went from 81 down to 6.8. It's a lot faster. Okay. Don't forget what you know about metric, that if you're moving over from like millimeters to centimeters, you're going to divide by 10. Okay. You're going to divide whatever centimeters by 10. If you're going from centimeters to millimeters, you're going to multiply by 10. Okay. That's one of the things that's on the homework. It's got a couple of those. Okay. Let's take a look. So your last little bit I want you guys to do, here's your ticket out the door. Let me clear this off so you guys can see it. You're going to write about how the area formula for parallelograms, rectangles, and triangles helped you with this lesson. So we kind of talked a little bit about this and we thought about it, because there's parts from triangles, there's parts from parallelograms and rectangles that help us lead that idea to get to our formula of area equals 1/2 of base 1 plus base 2 equals height. Okay. Now, there are other ways to think of it. So I want you to stretch your mind and see what you could do to figure it out. Now, that you're going to work on your homework next. You should have plenty of time to finish that. What you're then going to do, what your actual homework will be, is I've got a scavenger hunt for you guys to work on. Let me pull it up for you and show you what I'm looking at. Get to the first page. So what you guys are going to do is I'll have these scavenger hunt cards. They're listed around the room, and there's a couple out in the hall, just really close by. You're going to have to use the different formulas you know for trapezoid, for parallelogram, and for triangle, and get the answers. Now, this right here is the answer to the other card. So this one right here is an answer to a different problem. So this is not the answer to 12 times 24. Okay, that's going to lead you to another problem, and then that'll be your answer. And you can definitely tell it's not the same, because this would be areas centimeters, but this answer is in inches. So it's going to lead you around the room. You've got, I have 16 cards that are up hanging up around the room. And then once you finish that up, you're done. This, and if you don't finish this in class, it's going to become homework for you. So it gives you guys plenty to work on. If you have questions, ask the sub. And if there's any questions, feel free to email me. I'll keep an eye on my email and see what I've got. Okay. All right. Good luck. I look forward to seeing you guys Friday.